Hey everybody, how's it going? Today, let's take a detailed look at the all-new 2014 Rolls Royce Wraith.
And this is going to be a detailed, in-depth view of the all-new Wraith. We'll start it up, show the engine, get an exhaust clipping over the performance data, take it on a test drive, and show you a bunch of the unique aspects of the interior as well as exterior.
And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up. Let her run.
And before we begin, I'd like to give a big thanks and special shout out to Rolls Royce Motor Cars for inviting me out to film and drive the Wraith during the North American launch event in Scottsdale, Arizona. Also to Dean Farrell of Architect Photography for taking some awesome driving shots during our drive route. The Rolls Royce Wraith is essentially a two-door adaptation of the Ghost sedan. Therefore, as you would expect, many of the electronics and features found in the Ghost will also be found in Wraith. Throughout the interior portion later in the video, I take an in-depth look at the interior features, infotainment systems, and ergonomics. These clips were filmed using a Ghost. Just a quick FYI, while the Wraith features a slightly updated style with its infotainment system, everything between the two vehicles works in the same fashion. For comparison, I'll also show some side-by-side shots between Ghost and Wraith to point out key differences. Thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you guys enjoy the video.
Now, as you do expect, the new Ghost does come standard with an integrated smart key access system, so all you have to do is just keep the key fob in your pocket and utilize the touch sensors on both the door handles to lock and unlock the vehicle. To lock it, just tap this little indentation here. One beep indicates locking, then after waiting a second, just grab the handle and automatically unlocks the vehicle. If you go to close the door and fail to close it all the way, it'll also bring it closed to the frame via an integrated suction mechanism. The exterior colors are Salamanca blue, featuring a full premium seashell leather interior with navy accenting.
And along with that smart key system, as you would expect, the Wraith does come standard with a remote push-button ignition. All you have to do is put your foot on the brake and hit the dash mounted button to start. Beautiful. Wraith features speed proportional power assist steering that adjusts the feedback and responsiveness based on your current speed, designed to be more direct and precise for a better driving profile. The traditional 3-spoke thin-rim leather-wrapped steering wheel is actually slightly thicker on the Wraith than the other Rolls-Royce models, and also features plenty of black piano veneer across the spokes and chrome-plated switchgear. As far as the gearbox, Wraith features a ZF-sourced 8-speed automatic transmission. Simple to use, you just depress the brake, pull down the stalk to drive, push up for reverse, or half a click for neutral. The low button, when activated, holds the gears longer between shifts. To put it in park, just hit the button at the tip of the stalk. Wraith is also the first Rolls-Royce model to debut a new piece of technology known as the satellite-aided transmission. It uses GPS data to predict the correct gear for what lies in the road ahead, whether it's a hairpin turn or a straightaway, allowing for more responsive gear changes and performance when demanded. Put the vehicle in reverse and your backup camera automatically appears, also with adjusting guidance lines and obstacle marking. The 360-degree cameras allow you to see the corners of the vehicle to assist in parking such a large car. So we're going to flip on the automatic LED headlamps, as well as the hazards. Naturally, all four windows are fully automatic, with laminated glass for better safety and noise isolation. And we're going to check out the exterior, shall we? Rolls Royce Motor Cars has been producing some of the world's finest luxury automobiles for over a century now. While new models have come and gone, the tradition of old-world British craftsmanship has always stayed strong as it's adapted to the modern era. While the brand's long and illustrious history is filled with exciting stories, like many car companies, it's also had its shares of ups and downs. Namely towards the late 1990s when the outdated Silver Spurs and late Seraphs had lost that famed glimmer that truly made a Rolls-Royce something special. When BMW acquired the brand in 1998, motions were then set in place that would forever change the brand to reclaim that historical moniker of building the best cars in the world. Through the research and development phase over the next 4 years, the first all-new Rolls-Royce in almost 40 years was ready to debut to the public January 2003. Designed with input from Rolls-Royce owners themselves, the all-new Phantom paved the way to expand the brand's lineup even further than ever before. Not only with new models like the Phantom Coupe and Drophead, but in the past few years, the brand has been able to reach a whole new demographic of younger purchasers. With the introduction of the Ghost, buyers who were more likely to drive their Rolls-Royce were still able to choose an alternative that was slightly less intimidating and bold, but still a thorough Rolls-Royce. Last year, Rolls-Royce broke their all-time sales record, originally set back in the 1970s. 2013 looks to beat it yet again. One of the co-founders of Rolls-Royce, Sir Henry Royce, once said, "Take the best that exists and make it better. If it does not exist, design it." That famous quote couldn't be more perfect in describing the last decade for Rolls-Royce and the all-new Wraith, a coupe version of the Ghost sedan. With a profile and demeanor unlike anything in Rolls-Royce's portfolio or on the road today. While not a sporting vehicle, it is the fastest, most powerful Rolls-Royce ever built. It's a supremely comfortable, relaxing environment packaged in a sleek fastback that could sprint to 0 to 60 in a brisk 4.4 seconds. Wraith was first introduced back in March of this year at the Geneva Motor Show. It revives a historic nameplate first used back in 1938 and is designed to broaden demographics even further by appealing to a younger crowd who may be fans of the brand but don't necessarily need a limousine. The overall design and feel is supposed to emulate styling cues of the 1930s without being retro, and is pretty much the closest thing you could find to a coach-built car this day and time. The Wraith bears some resemblance to the Ghost, but a closer look will reveal the re-sculpted front clip with a more aggressive air intake system and lower air dam. There's also a touch of extra bright work and a modified version of the traditional Rolls-Royce grille. It was recessed inward 1.8 inches compared to the Ghost and lengthened by 1.6 inches. The Spirit of Ecstasy figure that has been the forefront of the brand's identity for just over 100 years has also been modified for Wraith. Tilting her 5 degrees forward and further towards the edge emulates the dynamic nature of the vehicle. The LED turn signals are positioned to make the fascia more aggressive, while adaptive LED headlamps and tail lamps provide modern lighting. The overall profile features a long hood, low roof, and high waistline, with a deliberate separation of the greenhouse that can be further accentuated with optional two-tone paint schemes. From the side, the lines run unbroken from the front to the rear and cause your eye to naturally trail to the rear, as if the car is in motion. The Ghost rides on a modified BMW 7 Series platform, as does the Wraith, only it's been further modified. Compared to the Ghost, the Wraith's wheelbase is 7.2 inches shorter, the rear axle is 0.95 inches wider, and height decreases by 1.97 inches. Wraith is built around a central steel monocoque on top of a steel unibody, featuring double bulkheads up front for better noise isolation. Steel is the material of choice as it also makes up many of the body panels, aside from the aluminum hood and composite deck lid, which houses the radio and GPS antennas and keeps them from view. The word bespoke comes from unique, buyer-specific requests, options to be spoken for, and perfectly describes Rolls-Royce's coach-building division, where the sky is the limit as far as personalized options to your Rolls-Royce. After applying paint, the vehicle is wet-sanded by hand between coats, and the final clear coat is then hand-polished for hours to give it that mirror finish. Optional pinstripes are evenly placed using a squirrel hair brush by a single individual. The pinstripes can also take several hours to stripe. At the Goodwood plant in Sussex, England, you won't find assembly lines or machines building the cars. They're manually taken from station to station, one of the last factories of its kind. All in all, it can take a couple months for a standard optioned Wraith to be built. It can take several months or even a year depending on the model, level of options, and bespoke requests. The Wraith comes standard with asymmetrical 20-inch polished aluminum alloy wheels, while 21s are also available. They can be had with the color-matching center caps like the one here, and the self-leveling double R logo. They're wrapped in Goodyear Eagle run-flat tires measuring 255-45 in front and 285-40 in the rear. Brakes are large, four-wheel ventilated cast iron discs measuring 14.7 inches in front and four-piston monoblock calipers, or 14.6 inches in the rear with single-piston sliding calipers. The suspension is fully independent with double wishbones in front and a multi-link rear with pneumatic springs coupled to the standard air ride system with 3-mode variable damping. Ride height can also be raised or lowered at the driver's discretion to aid ingress or egress or avoid large curbs, but during normal driving it remains in the middle position. The anti-roll bars automatically adjust to control roll and pitch, while the overall suspension setup has been tuned to give a more dynamic feeling than any other Rolls-Royce vehicle, while still retaining its signature supple ride. Overall length is 207.9 inches with a width of 76.7 inches and a height of 59.3 inches. Total curb weight, depending on your options, is around 5,300 pounds with a near perfect weight distribution.
And we're going to pop the hood.
Wraith features an all-aluminum twin-turbocharged dual-overhead cam V12 with 4 valves per cylinder and direct fuel injection. It's also the same power plant shared by the Ghost, although the race application is a nice bump in power. The engine, built for Rolls-Royce, is a bored-out version of BMW's 6-liter V12 found in the 760 Li. In the Wraith, it produces 624 horsepower at 5,600 RPM, and 590 pound-feet of torque as low as 1,500 RPM. Compared to the Ghost, that's an increase in 61 horsepower and 15 pound-feet of torque. 0 to 60 times are around 4.4 seconds, while top speed is electronically limited to 155 miles per hour. As far as fuel economy, with a 21.9 gallon tank running on premium fuel, expect a range of around 15 city, 21 miles to a gallon on the highway. Entering the Wraith is like being cocooned in an abundance of safety and comfort. Open up the rear hinged coach doors and you'll be greeted by one of the most richly appointed cabins on the market, with phantom grade leather, rich woods, metals, and glass dash controls. Everything is designed to evoke the classic feeling while having modern, contemporary design elements. For the first time, Rolls-Royce has used what they call Cannadel paneling throughout the vehicle. The most dynamic portion is the doors. All open pour grain, it's a single piece of wood that's gently curved to hug the contours of the doors. The grain is also oriented at a 55 degree angle throughout. The rest of the wood of the vehicle is also bookmatched to echo the grain of the doors and create a mirror image across the center console. It makes you feel like you're sitting in the middle of a classic yacht. Rather than having highly technical 20-plus way multi-contour seats, the Wraith has simple adjustment for recline, tilt, and height, in addition to 4-way power lumbar. Color accent stitching and unique leather pattern accenting some of the bolsters that complements the center console. The Rolls-Royce moniker stitched into the headrest or your choice of custom options, and the seatbelts and airbags are integrated into the seat due to the lack of B-pillar. Built in up front, you also have the signature Rolls-Royce umbrellas for the driver and passenger. They easily pop out and tuck away if desired. Beautiful polished entry guards accented by the Wraith script welcome you in while the plush wool mats help reduce fatigue on your feet. The steering wheel's power tilt telescoping and the needles of the instrumentation cluster are accented in dynamic orange. Of course, Wraith features many of the newest safety features as well, including lane keep and assist, adaptive cruise control, a night vision camera, emergency brake assist, knee airbags up front, and more. There's also a digital heads-up display that beams up your speed readout onto the windshield. You can notice it a little bit more during the test drive. The optional Starlight headliner replicates the night sky with 1,340 individually sewn LEDs embedded in the leather of the headliner. You can also replicate constellations or have a certain pattern of stars that appeared on a significant date pulled from past observatory records.
So let's go and see how she sounds.
The Wraith also features power-actuated doors and a full power liftgate. To close, just press and hold the button. It makes closing the door with such a wide opening angle a whole lot easier, as well as add a little bit of visual excitement. Also, closes with a nice reassuring thud. It goes without saying that the ride quality of the Wraith is superb. The adaptive air suspension and dampers do a fantastic job soaking up the bumps while maintaining a composed profile on more windy roads. The steering is light with a higher ratio, which means you may have to turn it a little more while steering at low speeds, but what that gives is incredible smoothness and better response at higher speeds. Power is definitely noticeable with no evidence of turbo lag, even more so on the interior with a more pronounced engine note. The V12 is hardly audible while cruising, but just a touch of sound has been allowed to enter the cabin more than any other roller, again to enhance the dynamic feel of the car. Brakes are strong as you'd expect for such a heavy car, and you definitely feel safe while driving Wraith. Everything feels solid and very secure. The Wraith features a standard 18-speaker, 18-channel, 1300-watt bespoke surround sound system by Harman Kardon, all fed through a newly refreshed version of the BMW-based iDrive system, custom-tailored to Rolls Royce, and a high-resolution 10.25-inch screen. It's a hard-drive-based infotainment system with navigation and telecommunication capabilities. For the majority of the tech demos and the feature clips, we will be referencing the Rolls Royce Ghost. The systems work in the exact same fashion, but the new Wraith differs itself slightly with a restyled main menu and color themes. Just like the Ghost, everything is controlled via the glass inlay controller in the center console, dubbed the Spirit of Ecstasy Remote Controller. Everything you see in the Ghost as far as tech demos can be directly applied to the layout and function of the Wraith. As with BMW's application, the controller is located in the center stack, corresponding with your different menus and the like, and I'll talk about that in just a second. It's a fantastic audio system overall.
Old school 1057.
Side curtain airbags, chrome accented grip handles, your Bluetooth microphone, located on either side of the vehicle so all the passengers can be equally heard, chrome accented visors, integrated card holder, auto-dimming rearview mirror with integrated garage home link, also your SOS emergency roadside assistance, and controls for your interior illumination and ambient lighting. As far as the multimedia system, this is your main menu, where it has all of your different commands that you can scroll through, or activate on the little controller here. This toggle wheel in the middle can go up, down, left, and right, down for enter, hit menu to go back to the main menu, back, system options, radio, CD, telephone, and map. Everything can be controlled here or here, so whatever your preference really. CD multimedia up top, in-dash CD changer, as well as hard drive base, you have about 12.5 gigs of MP3 storage, hands-free Bluetooth streaming of audio, iPod, other auxiliary integration, so it's pretty flexible to whatever you want to listen to. Back to radio, scroll through the available stations in the area, different modes, satellite radio, weather band,
It's extremely easy to use once you get the hang of it. Tone, surround sound settings, speed compensated volume. Click the wheel left to go back to the main menu. Your hands-free Bluetooth telephone, storing numbers and voice dialing, storing messages. And your beautiful navigation screen. If you click the wheel to the left once, it brings up the different navigation settings, real-time traffic updates, preferences. If you click over to the right, and you can do this in any screen, you can option to split the screen so you have onboard info, or you can have your navigation off to the right where you have your radio off to the left. So it's a little bit of a customizable menu. Click over to the left twice, and it brings up all of your navigation, destination information, etc. Office, for those business-oriented individuals. Applications, concierge services, roadside assistance, as well as setting up service appointments, as well as vehicle information. You can search the owner's manual via pictures. You can spell it out, look it up by category. Like I said, if you're familiar with BMW's system, it's practically identical. Onboard info, fuel consumption, trip computer, and vehicle status. And system settings. A lot of personalizable options. But those are all the basic functions of the adapted iDrive system for the Rolls-Royce application. It's a beautiful blend of modern and traditional styling. Elegant analog clock located up in the veneer. Beautiful high gloss fashion to your more traditional styled air registers with chrome access vents and fully adjustable. You have an electronic parking brake up top here with your parking assist activation as well as auto hold function when you put it in park. Press this button to activate your front split view camera system for unsurpassed ease of parking. You have all of your preset station activation located down below here. You can change between the different radio modes, and you have your in-dash CD player. Press this button here to open and close the veneer cover. The lower portion of the dash is also wrapped in leather, as is the rest of the vehicle, also with the black color contrast stitching with this particular color. You have your quad zone climate control system up here with split level climate adjustment for the top and bottom air registers, fan speed, heated and ventilated seats, three stage for each side, front and rear defrost, as well as recycling through an advanced air filtration system to filter out excess pollution or allergens. Adjustable cup holders located down below there, as well as an ashtray and or power outlet. Your lock and unlock is located to the left there below the hazards, as well as your height adjustment where you can raise and lower the vehicle with the pneumatic air ride suspension. Soft, supple center console with plenty of storage and a space for an integrated telephone with a 12-volt power outlet. As far as the multifunction steering wheel, you have your radio controls, hands-free telephone and voice commands, help.
To obtain the voice commands of the displayed panel, say voice commands. To obtain general information on voice activation, say help with voice activation. To obtain important short commands with examples, say help with examples.
And you gotta love the British accent. Cruise control is located off to the left here. It's also a beautiful gauge cluster, very reminiscent of the Phantom, with a little bit more to it. You have a driver information system located down below there. This is controlled via this little stalk here that also doubles as the turn signal or the parking lamps. Push it in to change the menus. Basic fuel economy and trip computer.
To pull the seat back, all you have to do is just grab the chrome-plated handle, flip it forward, and it automatically locks in place, and there's a button on both the seats so you can slide them forward and backward.
There's no shortage of comfort and opulence for the backseat passengers as well, with the same leather materials, the Cannondale wood paneling, and the bookmatched center wood trim. There's plenty of storage pockets and cup holders, with little vanity mirrors in the back, we'll show that in just a second. There's also plenty of room in the rear seat for taller individuals, and a nice wide opening thanks to the door for easier ingress and egress. As you would expect, backseat room is quite excellent. Smaller than the Ghost, obviously, but plenty of room for people over 6 feet. I'm about 5'11", I have at least maybe 5 inches of leg space and probably about 2.5-3 inches of head space. The polished aluminum air vents with organ stops, as well as your independent climate adjustment for the rear. In the middle, 2 matte finished wood consoles, has your adjustable cup holders, as well as your lighter and ashtray. Full padded leather center console, LED lit, lined in velour with 2 12-volt power outlets. The lack of a B-pillar when the windows are rolled down really allows for a much more open-air experience for the interior. That chrome belt line also wraps around the windows, and in traditional Rolls Royce fashion, you have little vanity mirrors built into the C-pillars. Coat hooks up top, your reading lamps, and main lights up top, not to mention side curtain airbags for the rear passengers. There's also LED floor lighting. Alrighty. And shut her down. And we're gonna check out the rest of the vehicle. As you would expect in this modern era of ultra-luxury automobiles, a power boot lid is standard. Total cargo volume is approximately 16.6 cubic feet, and there's also some storage pockets to the side. The trunk is lined in plush carpet, matching the navy of the interior, keeping with the luxurious feel. And of course, two-person memory for the passenger seat, and all of the same power adjustments that you find on the driver's seat. Your umbrella is also located up here for convenient access for the passenger. The passenger side is also power actuated, like I mentioned earlier. And of course, good sized glove box, nicely padded, and velour lined, with your trunk lock, and it's also illuminated. The 2014 Rolls Royce Wraith is a wonderful example of hand-built British craftsmanship blended with a host of modern performance and technology. It paves the way for new and creative vehicles to enter Rolls Royce's long and illustrious vehicle portfolio. For those who can afford it, there's no better way to travel. A potent fastback with that signature magic carpet ride.
Well, everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the all-new 2014 Rolls Royce Wraith. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.